friends, I'm Captain Vijay. In this video, I'll be talking about cargo calculations. This video, I'll be explaining more or less the practical part, how a mate does his cargo calculations on board the ships, on the oil tanker as well as chemical tanker. I will be discussing only about the metric system. For the American standards, I'll be making a separate video. It is possible that many of the second mates and third mates are not aware of the cargo calculations, or if they want to learn, they can watch this video and this will help them so that they can go on board and then they can practice with the chief mate, and then they will have a fair idea of how the cargo stopping alleges and how the cargo quantity is being done on board the ships. So let's begin with my slide.
Tanker cargo calculations, practical use on board the ships. So I'll be sharing the cargo calculation used on board oil and chemical tankers. I will discuss, as I said before, I'll be talking more about the metric system used worldwide. I'll not be doing any discussion on the API, Fahrenheit, barrels, pounds per gallon calculations. Those calculations, they deserve another video, as we do not want to get confused. So let's talk some basics. Weight is equal to volume into density. Temperature rises, accordingly volume also rises and the density reduces. Temperature lowers and accordingly volume lowers and density rises. Remember, weight always remains the same. Now if you're loaded in Europe in cold weather and you're going to Middle East, so you should always remember that the volume will expand, the weight will always remain the same. So practically, when you are at the load port and the surveyor comes on board, so after doing the initial documentation and all that, so before you load the cargo, you ask the surveyor for the density. Then you clarify with the surveyor whether that density is in air or in vacuum. So what is weight correction factor? So if he gives you the density in vacuum, you just subtract 0.0011, 0.0011. Remember this figure. You will subtract this factor from the density in vacuum, you will get the density in air. So once you know your density, you again recheck your storage plan and cross-check for the maximum volume expansion that you have taken for your storage planning, which will be on 98% probably. And then recheck if you can load the same weight. If not, then you call your master, and then master will talk to the charters and the shippers accordingly. Once you have the density from the surveyor, so there are three types of calculations based on the density. So once you have received the density from the surveyors, there are three types of calculations accordingly. So I'll explain those three types. So once you have received the density from the surveyor, there are three types of cargo calculations that can be done. Also, as a bonus, I will share how to calculate stopping alleges for the cargo loading. Basically, most of the senior second mates and the mates would already know that it is basically going in the reverse order. So this is the cargo tank and this is the allege sounding or inage. So this one is called as the sounding allege. Basically, we deal with allege on the oil and chemical tankers. Below diagram is about the software that is existing on most of the ships that I have been on. This is a very common software which can be easily available in the market. Here you can see, you input your density in vacuum at 15 degrees Celsius, then you put the load temperature, and then you will get your VCF at that particular temperature. Just remember that this is the density in vacuum. Many times, many of the mates have, by mistake, they have entered density in air over here. So when we do the alleging on board the tankers, since it is floating on water, it is prone to trim and list corrections as well. Generally, as a thumb rule, we keep the list to zero. And on completion of loading, the vessel should be nearly upright. That is, the trim should be zero. In case you are unable to maintain even keel during loading, that time we'll have to allow for the trim correction. So trim correction is easily available in the allege table book as well as in the loadicator. So basically, this is your actual allege. This is your observed allege. So you are allowing for this correction, which is called as a trim correction. So for list correction, again, this is your actual allege. The allege that we measure using the tape is this one. So this is the list correction, this part. This is the allege table, which is common on every ship you will find. This is the allege in centimeters. Now there are various volumes at different trims. So this is trim by stern, the minus one. This is trim by head. Never ever load the vessel with trim by head. It's either even keel or minor trim, but never my head. This is the table 54B, the ASTM table, which we'll be using to calculate using the third method that I'll be showing it to you. Over here, this is the density at 15 degree Celsius, and this is the cargo temperature. So on completion of your loading, when you're doing the alleging and gauging, so you know the cargo temperature, and then you know your density, which is given by the surveyor, then you will get your VCF. Now this VCF will multiply with the gross observed volume. I'll discuss that in the next slide. So we'll talk about the method one. This is a simple method. In this, basically the surveyor will give you a density table. In that density table, it will be mentioned the temperature on one side and the density on the other side. Now here, the temperature, for example, I have mentioned 28 and 29. It is possible that the surveyor would have given you 28.5 and in the intervals of 0.5. So in that case, it is the easiest way to calculate. You don't have to think about VCF or density correction factor. You know the volume of your cargo tank using your allege table book or your loadicator. You allow for the trim correction or list correction. Then you multiply that volume with this corresponding density. So in case your cargo temperature is 29 degrees Celsius, so you know that 29 is 0.8650. So you multiply the observed volume, which is your GOV, gross observed volume, into the density. Again, I'll remind you, the surveyor will give you density. Make sure as a mate, you ask him whether this is in air or in vacuum. Do not make that mistake, assuming this was in vacuum and he had told me air. Once he says that this is in air, you just write it on the density chart, which he would be giving it to you. So 0.8650, this is in vacuum. So you subtract 0.0011, which is your weight correction factor. So you get this metric ton, which will be your weight of the cargo in that particular tank. So since now you know the basics of this method one, it will be very easy for you to make the formulas in the Excel and then accordingly copy paste the formulas and make it for the complete tanks. We'll go to method two. Method two is about the density correction factor. In this, basically the surveyor will give you the density at 15 degree or 20 degree Celsius. Air or vacuum, again, you ask the surveyor. If it is in air, no problem. If it is in vacuum, then you subtract 0.0011 to get the density in air. So for example, the pumpman tells you that the cargo temperature of one particular tank is 29 degrees Celsius. So the density at 15 degree is 0.8400 air. The surveyor has given you, or in vacuum, it would be 0.8411. The correction factor given by surveyor would be 0.0007 per degree change. Now this is the range of the density change per degree Celsius. This is just an example. It may vary to 0.00010 or 0.0001. The surveyor will give you the density correction factor. So since the temperature has increased, so obviously the density will drop down, the density will decrease. So first you find out the difference that you have to subtract from the density. So the temperature was 29. Your reference temperature at which the density was 15. So 29 minus 15, the whole multiplied into density correction factor. So you will get one factor that is 0.0098. So you subtract that from 0.8400 and then you'll get your density at 29 degrees Celsius. So in this method, what you're basically doing is you are adjusting for the density correction factor, and you are bringing the density at the required temperature, which was found in your cargo tank at the time of loading or at the time of discharging. So remember, density decreases as temperature rises. So you'll subtract from the density at reference temperature. Sometimes it happens that the cargo is loaded lesser than the reference temperature. So in that case, you will add instead of subtract. So you multiply the GOV of your tank directly by the new density that you have found out at that particular temperature. So that will be your weight in air. So now we'll talk about the third method. Third method is basically used for the CPP or oil trade, or on the chemicals where 54A or 54B is applicable. So I use the software, which is much easier to calculate the VCF. You can also refer to the ASTM table book, 54B or 54A. Now, what is VCF? VCF is volume correction factor. As a thumb rule, the VCF for 15 degrees Celsius is 1. That's standard. So when you load cargo, the server will give you the density at 15 degrees Celsius, which is common. In air or vacuum, doesn't matter. That you have to ask the surveyor. If it is in air, no problem. If it is in vacuum, you subtract 0.0011 to get the density in air. So basically what you do is, you don't have the density at the low temperature. Here what you're doing is, you're virtually reducing the volume of the tank to 15 degrees Celsius or the reference temperature. So that is called as the gross standard volume. The volume in your tank is gross observed volume, but the volume after conversion using the VCF will be gross standard volume. In the next slide, I'll show you the example. Now, since we know the GSV at 15 degree, you can easily multiply it by the density which was given to you by the surveyor at 15 degree to get the weight. So remember, weight always remains the same. Now let's check out this example. Here I've assumed the density at 15 degree is 0.8400 air, which was given to me by the surveyor. Now using the ASTM table or using the software, my purpose is to find the corresponding VCF using the density and the low temperature. So here low temperature I'm assuming is 29 degrees Celsius. Now pumpman has given me an allage of 428 centimeter. Using that and the allage table book, I found out that my GOV is 2301 meter cube. So now what I'll do is, with my GOV 2301, I'll multiply the VCF, and this will give me the GSV, which is the gross standard volume. So what I'm doing is, my 2301 volume at low temperature of 29, I'm virtually reducing it to 15 degree volume, which is known as the gross standard volume. So now this gross standard volume and the weight is generally found on the bill of lading and the mate's receipt. So you multiply the gross standard volume by the weight correction factor, you will get your metric ton cargo loaded. Now, as I mentioned, how to find out the topping allage for stopping cargo. Here the process is exactly the opposite of this slide. So from here, since you know your weight that you have to load, you will go reverse order. So you know your density that the surveyor has given you at 15 degrees Celsius in air. So you will find out your GSV. From your GSV, you will apply your volume correction factor. The pumpman or the AB, whoever is doing the alleging, he will tell you the temperature. And using the temperature and the density, you will find out your VCF. And using the VCF, you will find out your volume, that is the gross observed volume. Now you know your gross observed volume, so correspondingly you can find out your stopping allage using the gross observed volume. Now in this slide, again it's the same thing that I just mentioned. For example, we assume that one port, the cargo to be loaded is 1910 metric tons. Now the surveyor has given you density in air is 0.8400. So you divide this, you get gross standard volume 2273.809. Now this gross standard volume is fixed. but the low temperature of your cargo tank may or may not be 15 degrees. So pumpman tells you that the temperature of the cargo tank is 29 degrees Celsius. So now you check your VCF and check the density and the temperature. You get a VCF of 0.9886. Now you divide this gross standard volume upon the VCF, you will get your GOV. Now using this GOV, you either input this GOV into your loadicator and adjust your trim correction and list correction, you will get your stopping mileage, which is the fastest method, or you can use your Allis table book. But using the Allis table will be difficult unless you are having the formula in the Excel to find your stopping mileages. So it's all going reverse backwards. In the last slide, I'm going to share a simple Excel formula which will be very useful to calculate the interpolation. I have used this formula many times. So in my last slide, I'll talk about a simple basic Excel formula which will give you the interpolated value very easily. Now this interpolation is very much essential when you're using the Allis table book. On the left side, you write your both the alleges. So if your required allege is 1.50 as told by pumpman, so you know that in the Allis table book you have the 100 on top and 200 below that, so you end up these two range. Correspondingly, you mention the volume on the right side. Now in the formula, you have mentioned equal to forecast A3, which is this. Then B1, B2 is this. Then A1, A2 is this. And make enter. It will automatically give you 2250. Then you can just give a try. You can enter any values on this side and any values on this side, and you just write this value between these two, and then you will get your answer over here. So this is how I use when I was using the Allis table book. But as a mate, always try to figure out a way to use the loadicator to your maximum advantage. So I hope you liked my presentation, and I was trying to be a little bit faster because I don't want this video to be long. In case you want any other videos on any other topics, just drop in a comment and subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram. So this is Captain Vijay signing off.
Subscribe to Papa's channel, hit the bell icon, follow him on Instagram.
Thank you.
Thank you.